Once you open Blender, it will ask you what type of new file you want to open. Click General so we can proceed to the 3D viewport. A 3D viewport is like the world where all the objects will be placed and operated. It is the big space that you can see on your screen. Now, I will just turn on my shortcut viewer so that you will see which keys on the keyboard I am pressing. This is not required for you to do. Okay, we can start off by deleting all the objects in the 3D viewport. We can do that by highlighting all the objects and then right-click, then select Delete. Or, you can also press A to select all the objects present and press Delete on your keyboard. To rotate the view, you can use and hold the middle button or the scroll wheel of your mouse. Alternatively, you can use the gizmo right here to also rotate the view. I suggest going over the overlays drop-down button here on the upper right corner and enable text info and statistics. We will be needing these later on once we start creating. First tip for beginners, you can simply hover your mouse above the tools and their names will be displayed. This is really helpful if you have trouble finding the tools that I am mentioning as we go through. The text info shows the current point of view that we are facing. Now that we don't have any objects present at the 3D viewport, we don't know where we are currently oriented. So, with the help of a gizmo, when we rotate the viewport, the text info shows the left, back, right, and front view. To zoom in or out, you can scroll up or down the middle button of your mouse. But again, if you don't have any mouse with you, you can use the zoom button here on the right side of the screen by clicking it and sliding your trackpad upward or downward. To move the view, press Shift and hold your mouse's middle button while panning the screen. Alternatively, you can also use the Move button on the right side of the screen, just under the Zoom button. Now that you know the basic controls on the interface of Blender, we can now proceed to the objects. Next is, we will be importing the 3D mask object that we have downloaded earlier from the studio guides. The 3D mask object, together with the creator base set and the templates provided by ZEPETO in the studio, are all in the form of an FBX. An FBX is a file format for 3D assets so that we can use and edit them to other programs not limited to 3D softwares. So starting from now, we will be working a lot on this file type. To import an FBX, go to File, Import, then FBX, and then locate which folder you have saved the FBX. I made a separate folder that is intended only for the FBX provided by ZEPETO just to be organized. So when it comes to the organization of files, I will leave that to you because each of us here have our own workflow. But I will repeat, just make sure that once we use specific files, you know where to find them. But locating which folder we have saved the files is sometimes confusing because we still need to open the folders one by one just to find it. Here's a tip. What I do is I will create a bookmark so that I can open the folder where I saved the FBX instantly. So, I will go back again to File, Import, FBX, and here on the left side of your screen, you will see the Bookmarks tab, but it is still empty. So, to create a bookmark of the folder, you have to find the folder that you want to create a bookmark for. Personally, I have them saved on my desktop, so I will go to the folder and open it and then click the plus sign in the Bookmarks tab. So the next time that you will open Blender and import assets, you can just navigate the Bookmarks tab for easy access. What you can now see is a dummy avatar which is called the mask. For beginners, the mask is where we will make our clothes from because it follows the natural shape of our avatar. Before anything else, please be informed that we have the undo function by pressing Ctrl and Z. This is really helpful if ever you made any mistake throughout the process. We also have the redo function, which is by pressing Ctrl, Shift, and Z. We can move the object by selecting it and using the Move button on the left side of the screen and drag it using the arrows that represent the different axes. The yellow line represents the Y axis, the red for X axis, and blue for the Z axis. For the shortcut key, press G and the object will automatically follow where your cursor points. If you wanted to move on a certain axis, say for example on the Y axis, press G and then Y on your keyboard. Do the same for the other axis by pressing G and then followed by pressing X or Z. We can also rotate the object by using the rotate button again on the left side of the screen. Rotate it to whatever axis you want it to rotate. The shortcut key for rotate is R. If you want to make the object bigger or smaller, we can scale it down by pressing S and moving your mouse. Or simply use the scale button on the left side of the screen. To edit and modify the mask, we need to go to Edit Mode. Click Object Mode right here and you will see several drop-down modes. Click Edit Mode. Or you can also press Tab on your keyboard while you are in Object Mode. The small dots you see are called vertices. They are like the atoms in the 3D world, and without it, we wouldn't be able to create anything. To move a single vertex, press G on your keyboard, which is the shortcut for grab. The vertex will automatically follow where your cursor points. Alternatively, you can use the move button on the left side of the screen and use the arrows to whatever direction you like for the vertex to move. We can also select multiple vertices at once. We can do that by highlighting all the vertices that we'd like to edit, or we can press Shift and select the specific vertex that we want to move. However, if you want to deselect a certain vertex, press Shift and click the vertex again that you want to stay in place. If we click the second button beside the edit mode, we will be able to go into edge select. This means that instead of selecting vertices, we can select the edges instead. These lines are called the edges. Beside the edge select button is face select. We will be able to select the faces instead of the vertices and edges. The faces are the polygons built up by the vertices and edges, which are the shapes you see right now. You can also have the choice to turn on all the component selection so that you can edit the vertices, edges, and faces simultaneously. We will be using these modes once we start creating. For the other features, we will just discuss them thoroughly as we go through the process of item creation. That's it for now for the basic terms and controls you have to know. I will be giving you some time to master these controls and then we will proceed to creating. See you in the next video. Bye!